everyone. Warmly welcome to the SACMO English Club channel, a wonderful place for improving your knowledge through English.
I'm Ngao. Today, we will discover traditional custom from three regions of Vietnam. Four panel traditional dress, Northern. In the legend, the four panel traditional dress appear in the Hai Bai Trưng Revolution. However, some people believe that because of the old textile technique, which could only weave the fabric of small size, it was hoped to sew a dress by putting four pieces of cloth together, known as áo tứ thân. The back of áo tứ thân had two pieces of cloth of the same color put together. When worn, the front had two separated flaps tied together and dropped in front of the belly, creating softness and flexibility. The upper did not have buttons, and áo yếm inside was visible. Áo tứ thân was long near the heel and is usually worn with black seal trousers and color seal belts. Along with áo tứ thân, there must be áo yếm, kerchief, and a flat palm hat with fringes. Until now, this image has been maintained in Quang Họ, love duet singing areas of Kinh Bắc. Four panel dress is a traditional cloth that reflects Vietnam's cultural variety because it's captivate in a particular way as well as celebrates the beauty of the hardworking and rustic old woman. Not only that, but áo tứ thân's design has a unique core value. Two flaps in the front and two flaps in the back symbolize tứ thân phụ mẫu, meaning the four parents, the birth parents and the parents-in-law. Áo yếm inside represented the parents holding their baby in their lap. It can be said that áo tứ thân is always a familiar representation of Vietnamese people and culture at any time. Vietnamese traditional long dress, Central. Vietnamese traditional long garment was officially born in 1970 and has been reserved until now. The typical image of Hue girls is that the long purple dress creates a slender, timid, but equally shy, gentle appearance. From waist down, the dress split into front and back flaps. The sleeves are measured from the shoulders, sewed together seamlessly, and reformed in length according to the wearer's needs. Now today, áo dài is worn together with long trousers instead of the old black dress. However, since the fashion industry has evolved, trending toward modern, some details have been reformed to meet the wearer's taste while still preserving the Vietnamese people's traditional values and culture. According to UNESCO criteria, áo dài has been and is in the process of being added to the list of intangible cultural heritage and then advanced to enroll in the list of the intangible cultural heritage of humanity. Áo dài is the Vietnamese soul beauty. Despite spending thousands of years in the north and hundreds of years under the yoke of French colonialism, Vietnamese culture has not been corrupted and áo dài has become the nation's pride. It has a seductive and sensual feature that is distinct from other civilizations. Vietnamese silk pajama, Southern. Áo bà ba, also known as a loose-fitting blouse that appeared in the 19th century, is one of the traditional customs of the South. Áo bà ba has no collar. The back of the shirt is sewn by a piece of raw fabric. The front consists of two pieces, and in the middle, two buttons straight run from the top down. Shirt cheek waist, sewing just right on both sides, has added beauty to the shape of a woman. The image associated with Alba back is a palm leaf conical hat and bandana that express the people of the South's inherent rustic, authentic, and idyllic beauty. Not only that, but Alba back also represents a stormy, resilient, and irreverent Vietnamese lady in the face of the country's salvation. When Vietnamese people think of Alba back, they generally think of their moms, sisters and grandmothers in the South, people who are both rustic and simple as well as close. Every time you return to the South, you'll see photos of farmers wearing Alba back, sewing and participating in rivers activities. From ancient times to this day, through each period, traditional Vietnamese custom have a distinct beauty that ultimately reflects the connectedness between the three North, Central, and South regions. Each outfit is a regional cultural feature that creates variety and richness while betraying the attractiveness of not only gentle, slim, elegant, courtesy, but also strong and resilient Vietnamese women. Thank you very much for watching. Have a productive and enjoyable week of learning and working.